Barrels of flour, 300 sides of bacon, 20 sacks of beans, 200 pounds of dried apples.
What's that, 12 cents a pound?
Mm-hmm. Take it or leave it.
You got me there. How much does all add up to?
$208 in coin. I don't accept no paper or bank drafts.
Mm.
Oh, well, how about some tin goods? I could make you a price on Ohio peaches. Now, they're real toothsome.
I'm not catering a banquet.
That's it.
What's this? Delegation?
Mr. Hale, I took the liberty of speaking to Colonel Manchester about providing us with a cavalry escort.
That's quite a liberty, isn't it? Considering I'm the wagon master.
Now, looky here, Mr. Hale. The judge was just figuring to use his influence.
I'm sure the colonel was impressed. Did he explain he's closed the trail beyond here to civilian travel for the duration of the Indian trouble?
Just where does that leave us, Mr. Hale? There's an Indian war and we can't go on.
We can't go back east neither. We sold our home.
And if we wait here, we may not get to California.
You just given all the reasons why we're going to take the only other route available. The Fragua Cutoff.
Through the desert?
Have you been that way before?
No. Coop has.
I heard even the Redskins won't set foot in it.
There's not a more miserable 200 miles on Earth. But it can be crossed.
Shouldn't a decision of this importance be put to the whole train?
I've already called a meeting.
All right, sir, we'll be there.
It could be trouble, Chris.
Yeah, that's why we're going to wave the flag a little. Help the folks take their mind off their troubles.
folks. I know that in the past you all cheered soldiers off to battle. We don't wear brass buttons, but we've all been soldiers ever since we left Missouri. Our enemy has been the land we've been traveling over. And right now we have a choice. We can retreat, or we can attack. Now we can't march into that Indian war. But we can't outflank it by going through the desert.
How long do you think it'll take us?
15 to 18 days.
What about water, sir?
The Army's let me have tanker wagons. Nobody's going to go thirsty.
Well, what do you got in that wagon, Captain? A brass band?
Extra supplies. Enough in there to see us through any emergencies. Oh, yes, there'll be emergencies. You know, the Spanish call that desert La Fragua del Diablo, the Devil's Forge. Now, if you decide to tackle it, I'm going to tell you. You can expect every hardship that a cruel land can dish out. You'll curse days that'll fry your brains, nights that'll freeze the marrow in your bones. Most of all, you'll curse me for driving you on. But once we start out, there's no turning back. That's the only road ahead, our only road to California. Now I'm going to ask you, have you the courage to tackle it? All right, then, it's on to California!
Ishmael, has it ever occurred to you that too much truth can sound just like a lie?
Heat and dust, And more heat and more dust and graves and more graves. Four people have died from our train already. How many more, Aaron, dear? How many more before the graves are ours?
This desert's not going to last forever, Geneva. When we get to California, you'll...
I don't want to go to California. I want to go home.
Geneva, don't get so...
Don't touch me. Don't ever touch me. Until you turn this wagon around.
You do me a favor and not try to get so worked up. You're going to...
Lose the baby? Is that what you're afraid of? But just remember this. I'd rather not have this baby at all than have it born out here.
Now she's with the angels.
Simon Turpin, you see about making a coffin. Mrs. Latham and Hallie will dress, take care of the body. Pomfret the burial detail.
Oh, come on, Captain. I was on the last one.
Mr. Hale, I'll take care of the grave if His Honor has no objections.
Thank you, Ishmael. Now, the rest of you better try and get some sleep. We've got a long, hard day tomorrow.
Touch. Is that all death means to you? A mess to clean up? He doesn't care about us. Don't you see? He'll have us all in our graves, and unless we make him turn back to civilization...
Get a hold of yourself, Miss Balfour.
We're dead! We're all dead! We're dead!
I suppose we're gonna hold this funeral right away.
Like all the rest.
We'll hold it just before we pull out tomorrow morning. And if there's any doubt about the direction, it's west. I'll get back to your wagons.
Outburst. She put into words what everybody's been feeling.
I know what they're feeling.
Chris. Is what?
That's Castle Rock Butte. It's a small fort at the base of it. At least there was 3 years ago.
I have a camp there tonight. Lay over tomorrow, rest the horses, lay in some fresh supplies.
A lot can happen in 3 years. You sure it's still there?
Duke Shannon's finding out.
It better be. We're halfway into the extra provisions. These people are out of patience. You've already lost six.
Suppose you leave running the wagon train to me, Forb.
Doing out here?
Waiting my turn.
Stop talking like that.
I'm afraid. I try not to be, but I can't help it. Aaron, you've got to take me home. I'll die if you make me stay
honey,
in this place.
Honey, the worst is over. We're more than halfway across.
Then what? More mountains, more desert, more dying. Aaron, you've got to take me home now, today.
Honey, just once believe in me. Just once believe in me.
Believe in you? I believed in you when you made me leave Boston. We were safe there. We had comfort and privacy and everything.
Everything but the independence from your father and his money.
Was that so intolerable?
Yes. Yes, it was. You weren't my wife. You were his daughter.
Put that on my tombstone. I felt him kick this morning. So hard he must be a boy.
I can't take you home, darling. Even if I wanted to, I can't.
What do you want for your son? A cradle or a coffin?
Honey, Chris Hale won't allow anyone to leave the train.
That butcher. Oh, he's so obsessed with getting to California, he doesn't care how many people he kills along the way. Can't you see he's played us for fools? He wanted us to come out here, so he hung ribbon on a wagon and said, follow the red, white, and blue. Soldiers, we're sheep, and he's leading us to
honey,
the
will slaughter! You
go ahead! Go ahead!
I don't want you to say anymore!
Hit me! Go ahead!
Find.
Well, the fort at Castle Rock's been abandoned.
Abandoned?
abandoned.
Afraid so? How do we stand on provisions?
We got enough for just 1 week, counting the emergency rations. We can't turn back. Look for yourself. We can't detour through the Indian country. Nearest settlement's Green River, and it's 100 miles.
Who are you? Aren't you present?
Plymouth Rock sardines? Where did you get those?
Off a prospector I ran across. He said he bought them in a mining camp that sprung up west of Castle Rock, so maybe we're not too bad off.
How far? How many miles?
I couldn't get that out of him. He said he's been picking his way all over the desert.
Mr. Chris, they're ready anytime you are.
All right, Barney. Do keep this to yourself. I don't want these people stirred up any more than they already are.
All right. Alexis Balfour?
Yes.
Talk to you. Honey, please. Geneva. Geneva? Geneva?
Commend unto thy care this mother and child. Grant them safe lodging and holy rest. Thy name we ask. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Then?
And then... fire.
Well, Cope, what have you in the prison like?
That wagon was doused in kerosene.
It's your fault. It's all your fault. We're all going to starve.
You're not going to starve. Now listen to me. Do you see that butte over there? That's Castle Rock. There's a fort at the base of it, and there's supplies there. That's one day away. You can see it. Now, we can do one of three things. We can turn back and die. We can stay here and die. Or we can go on ahead. Now, what's it going to be? What's it going to be? I say we're going on to Castle Rock.
Take him out of the hands of that mob. Your husband burned a supply wagon.
I suppose that means we'll be going home now.
No, ma'am, Aaron took care of that. No way we can turn back without that extra food. Sure out to lynching.
About that fort being at Castle Rock, Chris, because you couldn't do anything else. Where do we go from here?
Well, that mining camp prospector told you about's our best hope.
Well, maybe if you told the folks about it after they calmed down.
They never believed me after I lied to them. But maybe they'd believe that prospector. Do you think you could find him and get him to Castle Rock by sundown?
I don't know.
Well, try. Now, slow down the wagons as much as possible. Delay and pray.
Well, I'll catch up with Coop and let him know what the score is.
You won't tell anybody anything.
Not even Coop?
Nobody. Once they find out they've been lied to, they'll be out for blood. This is my lie, and I want it kept just that way.
What happens when they get to Castle Rock and there's no food there?
You'll be there waiting for them, with that prospector.
the land fresh.
See what I can do for your hands.
I wonder what's happened back there.
Told you not to worry about it. All Chris had to do was tell them about Castle Rock.
They didn't tear him apart first.
He's handled mobs once or twice before.
What is that, axle grease?
That's best I can do for now. You want to tell me how you burned your hands?
Setting fire that wagon.
Come off it, Boston. You couldn't lie your way out of a bean pot. It was Geneva.
What do you mean by that?
Look, you don't have to protect her.
Coop. I do have to protect her. Her mind is hanging by a thread. She wasn't even aware that she was burning up those supplies. She was just after the wagon, that's all.
Well, everybody knows she hasn't been thinking straight lately. Chris won't let anything happen to her.
Maybe he won't. Well, what about all those harpy women? You know what they could do to a coop. And frankly, she just couldn't take it.
Are you asking me to let you take the blame for her?
Yes, I am. People already think I'm guilty, Coop. We've got to leave it that way. We have to.
Well, I can't.
Coop. Coop. My wife is carrying my baby. Now you know what an experience like this could do to both of them. I have to ask you to give me your word that you won't say anything to anybody.
All right, all right.
Give me your hand.
Yourself a lot of trouble.
Oh.
Geneva's probably already told Chris.
No. No. Geneva's never faced up to anything in her whole life. She just doesn't know how.
Thank you. put you away. For him to stay with the wagons, or shall I keep moving?
All right, boy, you want to deny setting that fire, now's your chance.
How can I deny Exhibit A?
Did they tell you why, give you any reason?
No. Nothing that made any sense. I reckon he just went out of his head for a minute.
Is that what you want us to believe?
Well, you can believe anything you want to believe.
Seems to have recovered enough to stand trial. We'll make our noon stop here.
It isn't even noon yet, Chris. We can still cover him.
You heard me. We stop here. Hold the trial in 30 minutes. Forbes, you'll be prosecutor.
Now, those folks are getting edgy. We can't afford a delay. We've got to get those people to Castle Rock, Chris.
1 hour won't make any difference.
It'll make a lot of difference what happens to Aaron.
You heard me. Those are my orders. Anybody who doesn't like him can get in there with Balfour.
Curse this land. Curse you for bringing us into it.
How are we going to survive? I just don't know. What about the children? We're never going to get the children fed.
Mrs. Pomfret, some tin peaches. I thought you might have use for them.
Real Mrs. Goodbody. Think you're pretty slick, don't you? Well, let me tell you, this ain't gonna help that man of yours none. He's gonna get what's coming. Look it. She give me peaches. Thought it'd make us go easy on that firebug husband of hers.
No, I only wanted to help you.
No, it isn't! Oh,
maybe you're not as weak-kneed as Aaron thinks.
Did Aaron say anything? I mean, when you were alone with him.
Yeah, he asked me to see that you get to California safe.
What do you mean?
It's a good bet that he's going to be banished. That's the usual punishment for anyone who endangers a wagon train. I'll just turn him loose in the desert to take care of himself. That wouldn't hold for a woman. She'd be forgiven.
Are you suggesting that I take the blame for Aaron?
Don't let him take it for you.
Whatever you're talking about.
You know what I'm talking about. You set that wagon on fire.
If you think that, why haven't you accused me before?
Because I promised Aaron I wouldn't.
But that was before I knew about the trial. Now, either you tell the truth or I will.
Your hands are dirty.
Maybe you better take a look at Aaron's hands. Because they're burned and they're shaken, and that fool's ready to lay his life on the line for you.
I wouldn't expect an ignorant cowboy to understand why.
Well, maybe I wouldn't. But I'd ask myself, are you worth it?
Aaron loves me.
But you don't love him.
Why should I? I had everything in Boston, and he took it all away from me.
Does that write him a death sentence? Do you want him sent out there? You can save his life if you just tell Chris the truth.
Throw myself on his mercy? Not after what he's done.
He'll understand. He won't let anything happen to you. But you better start thinking ahead. If you let Aaron lie to protect you, you're going to have to live with it on your conscience for the rest of your life. Now you better face yourself, Geneva. Or are you rotten all the way through?
All right.
You haven't got much time.
I'll confess in private. Trial at once.
Geneva, I know how you must feel, but I'm doing the only thing I can.
Delay and pray? I was outside your wagon. I heard Duke say there's no Castle Rock.
Keep your voice down.
I kept your secret. But I'll scream it as loud as I can if you let those people send Aaron out in the desert to die.
I'm trying to keep him alive.
By having him banished?
Don't you see why? What'll happen if he's locked in that jail wagon when we get to Castle Rock? He'll have a fighting chance on the desert. I'll send Coop back tonight with a horse and some food.
What if Duke finds a prospector?
And what if he doesn't? No. I can't take a chance on having Aaron around to trigger a lynch mob. If they go after him, there's no telling where they'd stop.
You're only trying to save your own cowardly neck.
Now you listen to me. This whole wagon train's a powder keg, and I'll do anything I have to keep it from blowing sky high. Your husband lit the fuse, and he'll have to take the consequences.
He's not guilty. I am.
Oh, I see. Well, guilty or not, I've got to put him on trial. I need the time. I've got to have it. And you've got to let him take the blame.
No. The first time in my life I'm thinking of someone other than myself. Coop made me understand. Got to tell the truth.
You can't. I can help Aaron, but there's no way I can protect you.
I'll tell everything. All about Castle Rock.
Shh. You saw what panic can do. You saw how it can turn men and women into mindless animals. How it can drive them to self-destruction like so many sheep over a cliff. Now, if you want to be their executioner, you go out there and tell them I'm a liar.
What does it matter? We're all dead anyway.
We're not, unless you kill us. Geneva, you jeopardized 300 people when you set fire to those supplies. Now their lives depend on your silence. The lives of 300 people depend on your silence. Tell Chris?
Yes, I did tell him, but he wouldn't believe
me. You're lying.
He wouldn't believe me.
Either you walk over there with me right now, or I'll drag you over. Now take your choice.
Is Gordon come to order?
Well, take off your hat, firebug.
Settle down. This trial will be conducted according to trial court rules. Every man over 21 is on the jury. Judgment will be given and punishment decided by the will of the majority. Forbes, you read the charges?
May it please the court, the prosecution asks that this trial be postponed until...
What for? He's guilty. He was caught red-handed.
I was the judge. We're nobody more for holding a fair trial.
That's enough of that.
I have two reasons for asking for a continuance. Number one, we must move on to Castle Rock immediately without any delay. Number two, this boy has a right to a just trial. Now, he is not going to get it in heat and in haste and in temper.
That's a real judge talking, and he's talking sense.
And you're talking out of your head, you know.
That's denied. Read the charges.
It is the people's contention that the defendant, Aaron Balfour, did set fire to a wagon load of foodstuffs. The personal property of Mr. Christopher Hale. You did pay for those foodstuffs out of your own pocket, didn't you, Mr. Hale? The personal property of Mr. Christopher Hale. Destroying said goods. And asks that a suitable verdict be returned.
Heard the charges, Balfour. How do you plead?
Guilty.
You speak up, please. I don't believe everybody heard.
He said guilty. Now, I say we take a vote, and I vote guilty. What do you say?
Now, wait a minute. If this boy has something to say in his own defense, shouldn't we hear it?
Well, Balfour? You knew all our lives. Your own, your wife's. Your unborn child might depend on those supplies, and yet you set fire to them. Is that right?
The only thing he's guilty of is trying to protect his wife.
Mama, that's not true. She had nothing to do with it.
Are you going to let him take the blame for you?
I remember I seen her standing by the wagon when everybody was going to the funeral.
Are you?
But what is it? Wasn't she her? Now it's you.
Take her to the wagon. Get her out of the sun. Hallie, go with her.
She loses this baby.
you knew what happened, why didn't you speak up before?
Well, maybe I should have. Aaron made me swear I wouldn't. He was afraid of what you might do to her.
But we're not barbarians.
Mr. Hale,
this trial could have resulted in a terrible tragedy. Do we have a right to ask you why you insisted on it?
I'm up to my gullet with your carping. I don't have to justify my decisions before you or anybody.
Now understand me, Hale. I'm not questioning your authority.
Now get this, everybody! As long as I'm wagon master, you'll obey every order I give you. If anybody wants to dispute that, I'm prepared to deal with him for mutiny.
Now, this trial's over. We pull out in 10 minutes. The wagon master, right or wrong?
He's been wrong ever since he led us into this hell-burning cemetery.
Near as I can see, every time Chris Hale has been wrong, the judge has been right.
Tell me you didn't want that trial to go hard on Aaron. Why? Did you figure you had to serve him up like a roast pig to keep that mob happy?
Go ahead, say it before you pop. I'm ruthless, dictatorial, unjust.
You're none of those things. That's why I can't figure what's happening to you.
You don't call that the devil's forge for nothing. Maybe if you heat a man hot enough, all his impurities will rise to the top like scum.
I've seen you in rougher going than this before, and you never caved in.
Always has to be a first time.
Well, don't let it be now. Those people are looking around for a new wagon master, and they're looking straight at the judge. Now, maybe he doesn't know a cactus from a collar button, but he's fair and they respect him.
I get the impression you doubt my ability to run a wagon train.
Are you saying that everything you have done so far has been above reproach, Mr. Hale?
I'm saying that out here you're as ignorant as I'd be in that courtroom you're headed for.
Well, that's true, but it's a little bit different. A courtroom is governed by strict rules of procedure.
And out here the only procedure is west, and the only rule is get there. Everything I do is to get us to California. And every order I give has a good reason behind it.
Mr. Hale, you're asking for blind trust. If you were willing to explain your orders, these people might be willing to trust you. But all of our lives depend on your competence.
Just remember that if you decide to try to wear my hat.
Slow clap!
You didn't send a work party ahead to clear a passage.
Couldn't spare the men. It looks like it goes on and on. You scout south, I'll send Bill north, see if he can find a better place to cross.
We can't waste that much time, Chris.
Why don't we try flanking it?
These banks would never hold. You'd fill that ditch with wrecked wagons and broken necks.
What should we do, Smith?
Well, I figure we could break this down with blasting powder. We can move the wagons back about 50 yards and break out every able-bodied man with a pick and a shovel.
Are those your orders?
He's making more sense than both of us put together.
All right, I'll pass the word.
Now, what was the idea of that? You knew it had to be done just as much as I did. Chris. I get the feeling you're playing some kind of a game. And you've dealt me out.
Solitaire.
Now, this'll take a good hour. Why don't you get out of the sun and get some rest while you can?
You coddling an old man?
Make that an old friend.
Coop. If it should turn out that if I fall out of the saddle, I'm depending on you to take command. You! Not Forbes.
Keep on. Good, Ishmael. You shouldn't be swinging a pick with those hands. What are you trying to prove?
Don't think you working is gonna make us forget what your wife done. I say she ought to be locked up. First madhouse we run into.
And I say you ought to shut your mouth.
And I begged you. I begged you not to tell the others. Couldn't you see what she'd have to live with? Are you that blind?
Aaron.
I begged you.
Isn't this pretty?
Yeah?
I wore it the night Daddy announced my engagement to Aaron.
You neither.
My whole life was pretty then. And this chest came all the way from China on one of my Daddy's clipper ships. My hope chest. But now all the hope is gone.
You kept quiet about Castle Rock. You must have some hope left.
You're not frightened, are you?
I'd be a fool if I wasn't, but I can't afford to show it. Geneva, you said nothing to Aaron or Hallie. Now listen to me, Geneva, listen. I want you to make Aaron camp here tonight. If you have to, you can say you're too sick to go on.
But you don't allow straggling. People will be suspicious.
They won't notice. They'll be too anxious to get to Castle Rock and food.
Food. Food that isn't there. Because of me. All because of me.
I haven't faced lynch mobs and Sioux war parties without learning a few tricks about staying alive.
Alone? No, they'll kill you. They'll kill you. Time. We'll turn back the time. We'll turn back the time.
That's enough, fellas. Let's move out.
We're ready to move, Chris, anytime you give the word.
All right, we'll take a look.
Chris, we're ready to move.
We'll let them go across one at a time. After they get across, they can string out their own pace.
We'll let them strung out all over across the desert.
They won't hardly get lost in the snow.
What about stragglers? They can't follow a trail in the dark.
Hale, your orders are beginning to resemble the peace of God. They pass all understanding.
Look, Forbes, you might sit on a tall bench, but that doesn't give any right to.
I can still speak for myself, Bill. I don't want 300 hungry people all descending on that outpost at the same time. Now, is that reason enough to space out the wagons?
Why should there be any stampede? Didn't Shannon ride ahead to buy our supplies? Chris.
I don't get you, Chris. You haven't made any sense from the time that wagon burned.
Shannon said that the trading post was still at Castle Rock. We only have Hale's word for that.
Well, Chris wouldn't lie. You put it together wrong.
We'll soon see, won't we?
I'm gonna find out right now.
Wait a minute, don't be impatient.
If I'm right,
Hale lied. These people are going to rise up against him. The only thing that'll save us from complete chaos is a new leader.
You're not getting ideas about taking over, are you?
I know my limitations. But what I lack in trail knowledge, you have. Together, we could get this train to California.
All right, just for the sake of argument, what would I need you for?
Authority. And people don't like me, Smith. They think I'm too cold. But they respect me. And they'll follow me.
All right, let's get into line, Judge. We haven't got all night. Where's Chris? Across the gulch.
Morning, sir. Fire and smoke and folks all wild-eyed, thinking they'd starve. What would you have said if you were Mr. Hale?
I wouldn't have stooped to lying.
Even if it meant saying you might as well give up and die. You have no hope.
Geneva, I can't find her any place. She's not in the wagon. She's not
all right,
the campsite. I just don't know where she is.
Probably riding with somebody.
Nobody will have anything to do with her. She's an outcast now, Coop. Coop, you've got to help me find her.
Did he lie about the trading post?
To save their lives. Everything he's done was to keep them from going crazy again, but they will. They will.
I got to
help him.
I can't take the time to explain. You stay here. I'll come back for you if I can. I got to get to the view before those wagons.
Help him. Help me.
I thought you were a plane jumper.
Slocum. Slocum!
Chris, why didn't you tell me? What are you trying to pull?
I don't want you to have any part in this.
It's a good thing you spread those wagons out. We won't have to face all 300.
Not we, just me.
Chris, I'm beside you and I'm staying put.
Think about tomorrow, son. Things should go bad with me. This wagon train will need you. Now put that away.
Taking leave of your senses, Hale. What are you gonna do? Stay here and let them hang you?
How would you do in my place? Run away and hide?
I might do just that. I sure a sin wouldn't make it simple for them.
The mob likes to tie its own hangman's noose. I'm hoping this might make them stop and think and give me time to talk to them.
Talk to them? What are you gonna talk to those people about? After all, you led them into this death trap.
It's not a death trap. Unless they refuse to keep going. The mining camp west of here, Duke's out trying to get a prospector to verify it exists.
Duke's bringing them here?
We can find him in time. That's why I've been dragging my feet all day.
And the last thing you want is a showdown. Let's get out of sight.
Chris, they'll tear you to pieces.
I said stay here! You too, Forbes.
Why?
Because I'm the wagon master. Because those people are going to need me in a few minutes. More than they ever did. More than they ever will.
Nothing here, can't you see that?
He lied to us! Yeah. He lied to us!
He led us into starvation! This is a graveyard!
What are you asking for, Hale? For us to string you up, huh?
If that's what you want, at first I want you to listen to me.
Well, you're looking at dead people! You killed us, and we're all dead!
You're not dead, and you won't be unless you kill yourself. You almost did that this morning, remember? When our food went up in smoke? What did you feel then? Fear? Blind, unreasoning panic? Well, that's what you got to be afraid of. Not starvation.
You lied to us.
Yeah, you lied.
I lied to keep you going. I lied to give you hope.
Hope! Hope, he says. Well, hope feed our starving kids.
There is hope. When Duke Shannon told me this place was abandoned, he told me there was a mining camp. There, to the west.
I still think you're lying.
Yeah, you're lying.
How can we believe that?
I'm all for stringing him up. Now, who's with me? Who's with me now? Any of the rest of you?
All you gotta do is whip this horse out from under me. Who's gonna do the honors? Webster? Turpin? Otis? You can't do it, can you? Shall I tell you why? You stopped because you're good, decent men. No amount of fear or hatred can change that. I know you. I've known so many others like you. Honest faces looking west. Some to a judge's bench, some to a cobbler's bench. Some to a place where your kids can have the opportunities you never had. Come to a place where a man never looks down unless he pulls his boots on. You'll be the settlers and the builders. I respect you. And I envy you. Because all I'm good for is to show others the way west. But I've been proud to think that's worth something, too. Good way to spend a lifetime. If I've been wrong, don't hang me for a liar. Hang me for my real crime. For filling a great, clean land with the wrong kind of people.
Time for taking that collar off of him.
Yeah. That's
a good idea, I think.
Liar! Liar! Liar!
You all right?
She didn't know what she was doing. She just went out of her head for a minute, that's all.
So did Geneva Belcourt. Maybe you'll remember that.
Here comes Duke!
Who's that with him?
Where's my hat?
Chris, this is Mr. Slocum.
That Chinese carpenter never dreamed it'd end up here as firewood. Well, looks like it's about time for you to get up in the wagon and go to sleep then.
Honey, when we do get to California, all those things that I took you away from, I'm gonna get back for you. I'm gonna dress you up in fine clothes the way you used to. We're gonna have a nice carriage sent out from Boston.
All I want is to get better. And have your son. And start being your wife.
Better. I know you will now. God give us tomorrow.
Safe to pasture. It's been a good day's work, Mr. Hale.